Are you looking for a way to reduce the size of your video files? Perhaps in our new online world, you've discovered that uploading video from your home network can be challenging. Hi, I'm Ron Braxley, a digital media producer from the Mary Frances Early College of Education at the University of Georgia. In this video, we're going to take a look at Handbrake. That's an application which will do just that. It helps you reduce the size of your video files. Let's take a look. So here's the interface for Handbrake. We're going to step through the key elements of this so that you will have a better understanding of what you might need to do. And the summary tab just tells us that we are going to produce an MP4 file. I'm going to go ahead and click Web Optimized because this will be delivered online. And before I go any further, I'm going to give this a name, a unique name. The file itself is named This is Ron, and I'm just going to add the word comp to the file name to indicate that it has been compressed. And it's already set to save to the desktop, so that's what I'm going to do. All right, to compress the video, there are a couple of things that we want to consider. First, we're going to click on the Dimensions tab here, and my original video is 1280 by 720. That's the on-screen dimension of the file, the window in which the video plays, if you will. I'm going to change this, however, to achieve a lot of compression to 640 by 360. I'm going to do that for this video, but if you were planning to upload a video to YouTube or Kaltura, you might actually choose to keep it at a larger size and let YouTube or Kaltura do some of the processing for you. So I've altered my dimensions. I'm going to click on the Video tab here, and I'm going to stick with most of these settings. But what I'm going to change is I'm going to change constant quality to average bit rate. And the default setting is 6,000. Now, these default settings in Handbrake are to produce a high quality file. That is, a file that's less compressed than it might be. And I'm going to change the 6,000 to 2,000. Two-pass encoding and turbo first pass are selected. So what two-pass encoding means is that it's going to analyze the file in one pass and then do the actual compression in a second pass. And turbo first pass means that the first pass will be a rapid pass. You don't need either of these to compress the video, though they may result in a higher quality finished product. And then the only other thing I'm going to look at in this video is the audio setting. Now, my audio is already mono, but if it were stereo, I might choose to achieve a bit more compression by squeezing the audio down to one channel instead of two. If you're just doing spoken word, as I'm doing now, you don't really need stereo because all the audio is coming from a single point. So mono is a good setting. And then you can change the bit rate here. And 160 is a good setting. I'm going to take this down to 128 for just a tiny bit more compression. Okay. So those are all of the settings I'm going to change. And we have configured everything as we like, including a unique name and the destination. And then to compress the movie, I click the Start button. This is going to go pretty quickly because this is a very short movie. But a longer video would take longer to compress. Okay, and here is my compressed movie. I can open that with QuickTime. And this is the 640 by 360 window that I was talking about. And you can see that it has taken my data size down to 1.3 meg. Hi, this is Ron Braxley, and this is a video. Thanks. So that's it, really. It's pretty straightforward and easy to use. I wish you luck. Thanks.